I mean, it's like some kind of bad coil wine, but it's not just a coil wine, though, right?
I smell dog hair. Hair dryer. Hair dryer that's been in the closet since 1978 is what I smell. That is perfectly fine in any electronic. Oh, there go.
Oh, we smoked it.
Oh, what happened? Hey, Internet, Gordon, I'm with PC World. I'm up here at Intel's Power Supply Lab checking out some not great power supplies. I brought a few Gordon specials with me. We're gonna find out if they are any good or how bad they are. Hey, we're back here at Intel's Power Supply Lab. I'm here with Intel's Stephen Eastman.
Hello, hey Gordon, thanks for coming.
Thank you for having us. We had a great opportunity here because of all this wonderful equipment Intel has in its power supply testing lab. By the way, check out the other video talking about what they're doing for the community right now, compatible
products.
Products.intel.com, hashtag. But how are my cheap power supplies, Stephen?
Okay, well, Gordon, first off, when you make a power supply, you should actually list the rating for how much it is.
So that's, well, it has 700.
Well, that's there. Is that the model number, or is that really the rating?
I think that might be just the model number then.
Why? Yeah, anyway.
Well, it's 700 watts.
So the model number said 700W, so we assumed it was 700 watts. We turned it on to 700 watts, and it would not stay on. So sorry, if it's supposed to be 700, it's not a 700-watt power supply.
Okay, so I should change the sticker then.
Yeah, you should probably change the sticker. Now, we also went down to 550. It still didn't work at 550. At 500, we actually could get the test to run. So the report that we gave to Gordon that he's holding his hand, it does actually show what we did, and we ran it at 500 watts and actually got it to run majority of the tests.
Oh.
So it actually turned on and operated.
At 500 watts.
At 500 watts is a max load.
So that's why I disagree with the entire report I got back from Intel on my power supply. I didn't say I was going to pass these.
That's true, you did not.
What does this mean? Desktop CPU 35 watt peak loading test required and I failed. What?
So we actually define what between a 35 watt, 65 watt, and 125, that's our desktop processors. Based on the sticker load, we determine which one it's expected to test. So this one only works up to the 35 watt one. And then it wouldn't even pass the 35 watt test.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What about desktop CPU peak loading tests? That didn't...
Well, so the first one is the peak load test because it handled the peak load test. And then we get into some of the continuous load. Can it just handle 35 watts continuous? And it couldn't do that either, Gordon.
Okay, by the way, when you're in court or talking to a police officer, never argue like this.
Okay.
I don't understand what this means. Peak power excursions required, not tested. Okay, I passed this AC line regulation.
It just means the power supply turns on. But it didn't turn on. Well, of course, your sticker wasn't very informative, so we didn't know if it was 700 watts. But it did turn on at 500. But of course, right now, we're live on video, and we're testing 500 right now, and it still doesn't want to turn on. So we might have to derate it even more to get it to working today. But right now, it doesn't want to work at 500 watts.
So
you can see that 5-volt standby is on, which means, hey, it's plugged into the wall. But the other voltages are turned off, it's not even turning on at 500 watts. Sorry, Gordon.
What if we test it at 400?
Okay, well, let's try 400 there for
It'll
you,
It'll work.
Okay, so it turns on.
We're running.
Which is what line regulation is, hey, the thing turns on, it is working, the fan is going.
Pass. That's a pass.
That's a pass
I
for something.
I passed Intel stringent.
Oh, see, now it's actually on. And so you can actually see it's on. It stays on at 400, so you get 3.3 is out of spec. So your 3.3 is out of spec.
Well, what uses 3.3 volts anyway?
Oh, memory, other things like that. Graphics cards use 3.3. I mean, simple things like that.
But everything else is great. Look at that.
Yeah, your CPU might actually turn on.
Look, I bought 4 containers of these. They're sitting in the port of Long Beach. I gotta sell them. Timing. Well, what timing is not that important. What does that matter anyway?
Just when the power supply turns on, or when the computer turns on, does the thing turn on in the correct speed, or does it take too long?
Does it turn on, though?
Well, it might turn on, but, there is some more modern technologies that turns your power supply on and off faster, and you need to be able to turn on faster for that, so. Hold that time you failed, though.
I don't see fail. There's nothing on the form.
There's nothing on the form.
The ticket.
Okay. Well, sometimes when it's that bad and it doesn't get a form, it wouldn't even measure. So that might have been the case on that one there, is it didn't even measure, because that has to mean that we're looking at a certain criteria of order of things, and if things don't happen in a certain order, we can't trigger and get the measurement. And so it was like completely in the wrong order. So we didn't even get a measurement, Gordon. Okay. Sorry.
All right, short circuit protection is overrated, and I did fail that. But you did not test for overcurrent protection. Well, I'm certain it will pass that.
Well, we could totally test that right now that you're in person, but I wanted you to show in person.
I'm absolutely sure it will pass.
Because most of the time when that's a destructive test, where if I do that, it might actually like burn up your power supply, and then I couldn't show you in person how great it really is.
I am assured through my engineers, we have done our proper due diligence. It will pass. Let's do it right now.
I smell dog hair. Hair dryer
that's been in the closet since 1978 is what I smell. That is perfectly fine in any electronic.
If I wiggle the connector, you can see the voltage comes in and out of spec. Now, it's not supposed to do that. So this is what I'm doing, is I'm wiggling the connector and you're changing the voltage over there. Now, this again, not supposed to happen, but
you made it good.
Yeah, you can, if you hold it just right and push on the connector really sideways, you can get Gordon's special in voltage range. Don't touch it. It's actually working right now. Okay, we're finally passing one test.
Yes.
Okay, let's let it go and see what OCP does now.
OCP is overcurrent protection.
Yes.
How does that work? How does that benefit?
Overcurrent protection is basically if your system is on and you're pulling too much current. Let's say your graphics card or CPU, you pick a smaller power supply than what you should be for the system. It's supposed to OCP as an overcurrent protection. When you get too much current, it's supposed to shut down instead of burn up. It's the basic thing. It's supposed to protect itself and shut down, and then you have to actually flip the switch and turn it back on again. So it does actually look like the Gordon Ung power supply is passing OCP. Oh, and you got the pass.
See, we got the pass.
So you pass one. You pass one test.
See, this test is invalid. I want it changed. I need to talk to the judge. I want you to put a pass on the one test.
Okay, so now you're up to three passes out of all the different tests.
See, three out of three. Yeah, so we passed
three out of like
AC line regulation. It turns on.
And it doesn't burn up. There you go. That's all you need.
So would this power supply make your list of Intel recommended?
No, nowhere close. Sorry.
Okay, this is my first prototype model.
Okay.
This is my first prototype model.
Okay, now you have the blue one here.
What about other models? Or how did this one do? This is an old classic. Let me tell you, it's blue, which people love. That's gonna catch a lot of eyeballs.
Uh-huh.
How's that gonna do?
Well, this one here was rated as a 1,300 watt power supply. We could get it to turn on at 300 watts full load. And then we went above 300, it would shut off. So even though you have a whole bunch of cables and a whole bunch of extra stuff there, that one's not labeled right. And you got a whole bunch of wires here doing a whole bunch of nothing because you can only up to 300 watts.
But they are braided.
They are great looking cables. I mean, your cable person, your cable part of your organization, you're doing a great job. The cables look great.
All right, I got one more. We got one more power supply we tested. One way you can tell a good power supply is by, one, warranty, two, how heavy it is.
Oh, yeah.
Three, how it smells.
Oh, yes.
What I want to know is if I have one more power supply. How does this smell? Because that's what
yes,
I want
to it's know. Very important. You want to have a good power supply smell, don't you?
You do. Let's test this one out.
Okay.
Because we're going to find out.
Okay. So this power supply here, it's 1,600 watts. So Gordon's really jumping up his game for 1,600 watt power supply. This one actually works at 1,600 watts. So it's labeled and it actually works at 1,600 watts. So let's show you how good it actually works. Let me switch over here to that. And let's hit go and let's show you how this is working again here. So it takes a few seconds for the equipment to actually turn on. So what you'll see up here at the top up here is, so it's actually doing up here. So the very top up here, you can actually see this is on the AC side. So we're pulling 1600 watts. It is 2100 watts from the wall. It would be pulling right now, which is of course larger than what you, so it's pulling 18 amps, which would probably trip any household circuit. But our equipment's fine with that. So you're pulling 100 and 13. Oh, and what are you smelling there, Gordon? How's your power supply smelling there?
I think it has a very nice aroma, actually.
If you like Birdie electronics, it smells really good.
You can smell that. Can smell that.
Yeah, that's a really good aroma there, Gordon. I mean, at least it works to the rated power supply. I do give you that. That one's better. You're actually working at the rated power supply wattage.
See, we can do it.
Yeah, you're getting better.
It's still going, too.
Yeah, it hasn't turned out. The other thing is, it's getting worse. Now, if you pull over here back to again, we've shown this before here, is the voltage specs. Your 12 volts actually doing pretty good. And your minus 12 volts doing great. Now, your 5 volt standby, 3.3 and 5 volt are all out of spec. Here at 1600, so your voltages are out of spec as when we get to the 1600 watts.
And that would throw off just my
other components and stuff. Yeah, if and it depends on the range of, like, say your hard drive or graphics or whatever add-in card or memory uses 3.3 usually a lot too. Of course, that depends on the motherboard. The motherboard could pull it off a 5, but depending on the range that you have on the components, some components would be able to last and some would not.
Okay. But it's still working.
It's working.
I mean, it.
Some people might like it.
It's not that bad.
Yeah, I'd call that a feature.
It's not that bad. Okay. I was kind of waiting for it to blow up, actually. But it looks like it may actually.
Is it hot?
Oh, yeah. Don't leave your finger on that too long.
So just looking at this with the thermal imager, and of course, reflections make a big difference, but. It is hot. We're seeing where the heat is collected right about where that sticker is, about 157 degrees Fahrenheit. What's really kind of scary, though, is the right-hand side. That's actually outside the actual power supply, and it looks like we are getting a cable that is actually exceeding the heat.
Do you want to wave your finger over?
Yeah, so if I touch the actual connectors over here, that's 165. Over here by the connectors.
That 12 volt?
Yeah, was it this one down here?
Yeah, the 12 volt.
Yeah, that 12 volt connector right there for the CPU.
Is 162 degrees.
Yeah.
Oh, there go!
Oh, we smoked it. And you got
What happened?
Oh,
what happened to my power supply, man? Whoa. Why would it cut when you power down?
No,
or actually, starting to power down.
I was about to stop it, and it smoked before we turned it off.
Hey, your temperatures are going down, though.
Yeah.
Temperatures are going down, yeah.
Wow. Well, we ran it for about 15 minutes, 1600 watts, and finally blew it up.
Yep.
Wow. So if you're buying a Gordon Ung brand power supply,
mm-hmm.
How does the end user know when it's going bad? If you obviously, if you know you bought a Gordon Ung brand power supply, it's not going to be great. Is there any way for a consumer to be able to tell when their power supply is going bad?
Yeah, and so some of that stuff is like if it's just marginally failing, like it's really hard to tell when it's failing. So some of the signs are is, you know, like if your system is randomly shutting down, that's the biggest kind. But that's going to be an extreme case. Like it's not going to, you know, most of the time it's not going to work. The biggest thing is your efficiency is probably going to lose. Now, what's that really mean? That means your wall power is going to be more than what you expect. So it's going to affect your electric bill. Other things with the system's unstable. But there's some things that you're like, you really won't know as an end user. Like if it's a marginally good power supply, it's really hard to tell what is a good power supply unless you have this expensive equipment to really test it out. But that's where sometimes it's like, you know, it's the stability. It's all about stability in the system. And can your CPU handle things or stuff like that? Oh, your CPU, your GPU, as those are spiking and doing workloads, if the system becomes unstable or gets random blue screens, it could be because of the power supply.
Well, so there you go, folks. Clearly, my brand of power supplies are not going to make the cut. But thank you, Stephen, for doing the testing to give me the bad news. And come back to PC World's YouTube channel for more in-depth power supply videos with Stephen.